meeting will now come to order. I just found it was standing in the invitation when we did a November Carolyn Warren claim as for Pearl of Great Price Industries, and that will be followed by the President of the Senate. Let us pray. Almighty and Holy Father, before we consider a resolution, pass an ordinance, or make an appointment tonight, we first want to take this opportunity to say, thank you, Lord. We realize that without you, Father, the business of this great city could not be conducted. Now grant us the courage, wisdom, and foresight to provide for the need of all our people and to fulfill our obligation in this community. Help us to realize the purpose and plan for the city of Richmond. We ask that you continue to keep us in your perfect peace and your perfect will. In your sovereign name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Chairman, would you please give the chamber emergency evacuation plan announcement?
Yes, Madam President. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the formal City Council meeting. We'll now take a few minutes to go over the council evacuation announcement. Upon activation of the emergency alarm signal, all persons should immediately exit the building. Please use the exits to the left or right front of the council chambers or the east or west stairwell outside the rear doors of the chamber. Do not use the elevator or the escalators. After exiting the building, proceed to the assembly area located in the parking lot bordered by Clay, 8th and 9th Street. Citizens and employees should assist visually and hearing impaired visitors with exiting the building. Madam President, I will also take a minute or two to read a statement about the citizen speakers rules in the City Council chambers.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk.
Citizens wishing to speak on public hearing or citizen comment periods are generally allowed 3 minutes to speak. Persons appearing before council are not allowed to campaign for public office, promote private business ventures, use language of a personal nature which insults or demeans any person, including comments directed at public officials or staff members that are not related to their official duties. Address or question staff members directly. All questions are to be directed to the President of Council. Failure to adhere to the guidelines may result in speakers forfeiting any remaining time and further disciplinary actions as necessary, which could include barring from attendance at future meetings of the City Council for a period of 6 months.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Madam President, I believe all council members are present, except for Mr. Hilbert. Is Mr. Hilbert here?
That right here is absent.
Okay, and I would also like to recognize Mayor Jones, who is present.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. This time, we'll do the awards and presentations.